Can you name the piano player in all of these songs?
Gentle on my mind. Little old lady. Wish they all could be California.
When I was playing as a sideman, I kept my mouth shut. I didn't say anything to anybody about anything unless I happened to know the arranger or the producer, then I'd say something if I had an idea, but normally I didn't know anybody, and I just kept my mouth shut.
He had that magic touch on the piano. I don't know what you call down-home Southern-style piano playing that he did. It was magnificent.
And I was so taken with Al DeLore and his capability. And he put Al, later on, he put Al playing electric piano, which was just a fill kind of, I mean, just something to fill up the sound, with Leon Russell playing the acoustic piano. And I said, gee, you know, I thought Al was great. And he says, no, Leon Russell, man, he's got hands. He can reach octaves his, you can't beat that.
I figured out early on that if I wanted to be heard on the record, I had to play high. So I always played high, and all those high parts on those Phil's records, it's me. I did that so I could be heard. If you don't do that, you get lost, you know, in the wall, so to speak.
Leo never said boo to anybody, you know, he just come in, play his piano, you know. And so one day he came to work completely drunk. I mean, so drunk. And he went in and he sat down at the piano, and And who was playing next to him? Don Randy, I think. And everybody, I mean, he was actually talking. He never spoke. And everybody was like coming in, did you see Leon? And so everyone was like just looking at him, you know, and he was being really funny too, because I never heard him say a word. So Philip was like totally knocked out. But then finally he wanted the session to begin, you know, and Leon was just doing, you know, all this kind of crazy stuff. And so Philip said, you know, Leon, have you ever heard of the word respect? And Leon jumped up on the table, on the piano, and he said, Philip, have you ever heard of the word fuck you? And everybody, I mean, that was, I mean, they couldn't get it together for half an hour. People were like dying on the floor. I mean, tears rolling in the studio, because it was one of those, you know, the weirdest thing you ever saw.
The story, the way Cher told it, the Phil Spector story, that's absolutely accurate. First of all, Tommy was there that day that I did that horrible drunk bonanza on top of the piano at Phil Spector. The next day, Tommy came over to my apartment and said, Leon, said, I want you to go on the road and preach. I'll pay for the whole thing. I'll buy the buses. I'll buy the trucks. I'll pay for every dime of expenses. And you just give me a percentage back to pay me back.
We were on this date with Glenn Campbell, and they brought Leon in, and I'll never forget. And Leon panicked. He was sitting there. And Glenn says, Leon, just play that shit you did in Oklahoma. He says, they don't know nothing here. So Leon played Leon Russell.
Yeah, right.
And all of a sudden, they don't know nothing. That was his style. That's what they loved. That's what he did from there on it.
I'd play those sessions. We'd play tracks. We have chord sheets. So we'd play tracks. Sometimes we'd play them 10 times before we ever heard the melody, heard the singer. Just out of boredom, I'd write songs to those tracks as it's going by.